Hello, adventure riders from around the world. I really hope that you spend more time riding out instead of sitting here and watching my videos. But if you're here, keep watching, because in this video I'm gonna talk about the most important safety features like ABS, traction control and many other. Do we really need them? Are they necessary? Stay with me. Welcome back, guys. I can bet on $100 that you expect me to tell you now how bad is the ABS, because it is heavier, because you can use it off-road, because I don't have it on my motorcycle. But here you go, the important but. There is a phrase: everything what you say before but is shit. Everything what you're gonna say after that is what really matter. As you know, guys, I never talk just to listen my voice or to see my face on YouTube. I always follow simple logic and common sense. I told you this many times, my channel is here just to help you and many like you to make the trips much easier than me. Now I totally confused you, and I can bet even on $200 that you have no idea what I'm going to talking about. You cannot even guess. Anyway, I think that you already waited enough and I don't want to test your patience any longer, so let's go back to the topic. ABS or not? My personal opinion is that it's a great system and every motorcycle which is coming on the market today supposed to have it as a standard, as a stock option. And it is the same with the traction control, throttle control, uphill, downhill or whatever system you've got on your new motorcycles. Especially if the bike is with more than 100 horsepower. All of these systems could help you to prevent many accidents, and they actually can save your life in many different situations. Yes, but what about off-road? Nothing. When you don't need it, just turn it off. Even if you don't have button on the dashboard, you can always remove the fuse or even create a small manual switch and turn it off when you don't need it. It's like jacket in the summer. When it's hot, you just don't wear it. That's it. Okay, sounds good, but what about the weight? You always talk about the weight. Less weight is always better. Remove the weight, make it lighter, whatever. Yes, that's correct. The weight is always matter, but the modern ABS systems weigh no more than 1 or 2 kilograms. I'm sure you can find many more different useless pieces in your luggage to remove instead of the ABS. Okay, we understand even that, but you're riding a motorcycle without ABS. Why? There is actually, guys, 2 answers, short and long. I will go to the long answer because I really believe that it will help you to understand what I'm trying to say, to get the whole picture. I learned how to ride motorcycles when I was 15 years old. I did it the old-fashioned way, by doing a lot of mistakes and learning from the mistakes. Every time when I was going down, I was learning something new and I already knew why I get down. So I rode many different bikes and I even spent a couple of years riding dirt bikes. All of this helped me to realize and to understand how the brakes worked and how dangerous they could be if you not use it properly. Also, I understand how powerful is the front brake and how carefully it could be used, or if it has to be used in many situations. So guys, for me now, 30 years later, the ABS is something really nice. It's a great feature. If I have it on the bike, I'm gonna use it with pleasure. If I don't have it, it's alright. I can perfectly live without it. If my next bike comes with ABS, great, I'm gonna use it. But if it's without, I will not even worry about it. The reason I'm riding a motorcycle without ABS now, it's because when I bought my bike, the difference in the prices was really noticeable. And also, the version with ABS was about maybe 4 kilograms. Heavier, the suspension travel was short, and the battery was under the tank, which is not really convenient, because to remove the tank of my bike, it's a pain in the ass. Actually, it takes about 2 hours. That's why I choose the simple version, not because I don't like ABS. What I like in the ABS, first and the main, is safety. It could save your life or at least a lot of money and prevent many accidents, especially when the weather is not good, like rain, snow, or even worse, ice. The same, of course, goes to the rest of the systems like traction control, throttle control, or whatever system you've got on your motorcycle. What I don't like? I don't like the idea computer to control my actions. As you know, guys, most of the new bikes, they're equipped with this double brake system. So when you press the front brake, it's activate the rear. When you touch the rear, it's activate the front and splitting the power between rear and front, 60, 70, whatever percent they already calculated and did it and set the computer to work with. I know that this system is very intelligent and it's very clever and it's work very well in maybe 95% of the situations, but I still refuse to believe that it is so helpful. I still want to have my own control. I still want to know what I am doing and why I am doing it. I still want to have my own decisions, even if they are wrong, because at the end it is just a computer. It might be right in the 95% of the cases, but this 5%, they just stuck in my mind. As I said, guys, these systems are great, but let's see what it happens in the results of many years of use that system. For the purpose of that experiment, I will name one person, let's say John. It's a random person, I don't mean any John, I don't want to upset any Johns around the world. Okay, John is a new rider, he just got the driver license and learned how to ride a motorcycle. Of course, he rides now only new motorcycles with all of the system I just described. So after a couple of years, let's say 2, 3, 5 years, he will be already an experienced rider. He will know how to ride, when to press, how to slow down, and almost everything about motorcycle riding. As you know, it's not that difficult. Yes, that's right. Sounds very good on paper, but here you go, the important but again. What about if the system breaks down or if he needs to change the bike to ride, for example, his friend's motorcycle, which is the old system, brake front and front brake and rear brake, just the old-fashioned system. What about this situation? Do you think that the experience he get in the last 3, 5 or whatever years will help him to ride this motorcycle trouble-free? I don't mean to ride it just on the straight roads, I mean any kind of roads, curves, whatever. I think that he will be on the road with a totally wrong skills. Skills which one are perfect for a new motorcycle with all systems, but not very well with the old-fashioned bike without all of that stuff. I'll give you another one example. Friend of mine got a big adventure motorcycle. I'm not gonna say any brand or model because you always stuck on that and they will attack me after the video. Anyway, this is his first bike and he learned how to ride it. He's okay, he's doing some trips, he do really well, no problems at all, everything is great. But what he told me last time when I saw him, he said that he has some kind of problems with the rear brake lever. It was bended or something and he cannot press it properly. He need to go to the garage to fix it, but he said, no, it's not a problem because I don't use it often, and in fact I never use it. I said, you never use the rear brake? Why? How this supposed to work? And he said, yeah, because you know these systems, I stop only with the front and the front take the decision for me and stop the rear, so I don't really use it. I use only the front brake. I said, huh? Is this right? This is not right. This is not right. Absolutely not right. So during the years, he developed this absolutely wrong habit, always to stop only with the front brake. I'm not saying that the front brake is bad. Of course, we all know how important is the front brake, but it should be used only with purpose. And when you learn to use only the front brake, then you actually forget about the rear, which is not right. And let me give you another one example. Another friend of mine, he riding the last couple of years only brand new bikes, or expensive, good bikes, very good bikes. He is actually very experienced rider, but I said, in the last maybe more than 7-8 years, he riding only new bikes with all the systems I already described many times. But now he decided to buy an old and light motorcycle because he has the plans to go to Central Asia. So we're going back again to the topic of the last video. So these guys, they've got their heavy bikes, but when they plan something more, like adventure trip, they always go to the light. But anyway, it's a different discussion. So there is a link to the old video if you want to see the last video. It is here. So the guy decided to buy a very simple old-fashioned motorcycle because he wanted to go to Central Asia. So he did it. He went there, bought the bike and ride it back home. And he was so happy because the bike is light. It was cheap. He can actually make everything with it. So he was really pleased with the bike. But what it happens? He went into one corner, the corner which one he used to take many times with all of his bikes, many times. But what he did, right in the middle of the corner, he realized that he's so fast and he pressed the front brake and locked the brake and actually went down. Nothing really happened, he's fine, just twist a little bit his leg. But the result of everything is that what he realized is that he during these years he again developed these wrong skills to use the front brake, to trust and to believe that this all of these systems will work for you. And finally, when it happens, it just happens. So guys, these are just two examples how everything is working and how all of these systems could affect your riding skills. I'm not saying that they're bad. No, they're brilliant systems and they should be used. But at least you have to be aware about this stuff. So finally, to make my conclusion, ABS or not, I think that these are great systems and everybody should be able to use it and take the benefit from it. But what I will suggest, what I will recommend, especially for the new riders, to learn how to start properly without this system. After that, if they have it on the top, it's like a bonus. But first of all, you have to learn how to start properly without it. To learn how important is the front brake, to learn when you can press it and when you cannot press it. How to use the rear carefully, how not to slide with the rear and how not to go down with the front. All of this is not that difficult. It will take you time, but it will save your problems in the future. And after that, as I said, if you have all the systems on the top like a bonus, it will be just perfect. It is 2018, we don't want to go to the Stone Age and ride these old-fashioned bikes or whatever, but at least we have to know the basics riding skills. This is what I'm thinking about. All of this will help you to ride your motorcycle travel free if the systems you've got stop working or if you have to change the bike. So that's everything for today, guys. I really hope that this information will help you to take the right decisions. If you want to learn more about long motorcycle trips, go and check the rest of the videos in the channel. I have, I don't know, maybe more than 200 videos at the moment. I'm sure you will find answer of every question you've got. Or you can go and buy my book, How to Become a Better Long Distance Motorcycle Rider. Link in the description below. As usual, always ride safe and see you next time. Ciao.